The humble car battery. For years, it's been powering cars up and down Britain's roads. And it hasn't really had to change too much. It was simply used to turn a starter motor and maybe run an interior light. But in recent years, vehicles have become far more complex, more electronics, infotainment systems, even hybrids. The battery has had to adapt to that. But how, and what should garages look out for? So I'm here with Ecobat and with Chris Jones, who is Business Development Manager and works with technical support. Chris, could you tell us a bit more about Ecobat, the company?
Yes, certainly. We were founded in 1952 as Manbat. We've obviously grown through the years, and now we're part of the Ecobat group, which took us over 6 years ago. We are now part of European group, which is Manbat France and Hefra, well over in Europe.
Okay, and what is the battery range that you sell?
Battery range, we cover basically anything to do with the battery range, whether it be from leisure batteries, car, commercials, and in within our range we have our own branded battery, which is Numax. We have the Lucas range of batteries as well, and obviously we deal with Barter, who is a business that is an OE manufacturer and we've had dealings with now for over 40 years.
And of course the battery landscape these days is getting a bit more complicated. We've got, alongside standard batteries, we've got AGM, EFB. Can you tell us a bit about the difference between those batteries and standard?
Yeah, well, standard batteries, obviously, we had vehicles going back as far as the early 80s and the battery was only just starting the vehicle. Nowadays, we have stop-start vehicles, which are obviously coming through more and more. As a result of that, battery technology has had to change with it, as obviously we have more electrics on the vehicle. So EFB has come in as an entry battery for smaller engine vehicles, which gives you more turns of the key for starting. And the AGM is on higher engine sizes and vehicles that have more electric running, and again for stop-start, and again the battery needs to be able to start the vehicle as the amount of times it's actually stopping.
So what do garages need to be aware of when they're changing a vehicle battery?
Nowadays basically it's making sure we have the right battery for the right car. Within stop-start technology we must ensure we're either fitting an EFB or an AGM battery. Obviously we have a website which will give you a guide to finding the right battery, which also helps you with looking of where the battery is on the car and also the time in which to fitting. So batteries changing an hour are much different to what it used to be. Some are buried in the boot, some underneath the seats. You have to be aware of obviously where the battery is, and obviously we also now have vehicles that need coding. You have to basically tell the battery, or the car rather, beg your pardon, that the battery has been changed. So it's getting more technical all the time, so it's very, very important we make sure we have the right battery on the right vehicle.
It sounds quite like a complex situation, but it sounds quite easy as well in a way.
It can be quite complicated, but we have the tools in which to direct a customer onto certain things as a Varta website or our own, which does give the information. So once you know what is the right battery for the right car and how to go about fitting it, it's very straightforward.
Excellent, Chris. Thanks very much, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you.